Let's try the big one. High-intensity shockwaves, intended for the treatment of kidney stones, can be of use for Peyronie's disease. There are some pros and cons, but at the end of the day, there is scientific proof that they can crush calcified plaques within the penis. This can make a real difference, as it can save you from surgery on your penis. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist, and in this video, I will discuss the use of an ancient device that has shown to be useful in the treatment of Peyronie's disease. Shockwaves have revolutionized the treatment of kidney stones in the beginning of the 1980s. It started off as a treatment in a bathtub and gradually switched to devices with humongous transducers which are placed on the skin above the kidneys. It's almost like a video game. You aim at the stone with X-ray and pull the trigger. High-intensity shockwaves will then crush the stone. Already during the 1990s, there were attempts being made to use this principle on calcifications in the penis. Peyronie's disease is a debilitating condition of the penis with a high rate of underreporting. It is presumed that 1 in 10 men will be affected during their lifetimes. It is an inflammatory response of the tissues surrounding the cavernous bodies. As a result, the penis will bend at erections. In severe cases, crazy angles are reached. In addition to that, the penis will shorten. At the site of the inflammation, hard nodules form and some of them will accumulate calcium. These deposits are like limestone panels. They are hard to break. Shockwaves can do it, but not the low-intensity kind that's used for treating erectile dysfunction. They have way too little energy, but high-intensity shockwaves can. I had a patient several years back who had been treated during the 90s. The curvature improved substantially and he didn't have any problems ever since. I have sent one patient for ESWL. That's the name for high-intensity shockwave treatment. He had a very severe form of the disease. Here are two pictures showing one of his plaques before and after treatment. As you can see, the stone has been crushed completely. This was encouraging, but there are some drawbacks of the method. I will soon come to that point. But let me first introduce you to a case series of 110 patients that has been published in the World Journal of Urology this year. These 110 men were treated with ESWL at one institution during the period 1996 to 2020. Improvement in curvature was defined as a reduction of 5 degrees or more. This was achieved in half of the patients. Notably, the ones who did best were men with an angle between 30 to 60 degrees. 71% improved, whereas only 24% improved if the angle was less than 30 degrees. Also, erectile function improved a lot. They used the International Index of Erectile Function for that. If you want to know how it works, please watch this video. The median IIEF scores were 14 points, denoting moderate erectile dysfunction. After treatment, the median score rose to 21 points. 21 points is almost normal function. Only 11% of the patients had to undergo surgery, which is a low number. However, I also have to tell you that 16% of the patients reported a deterioration of their status. I will link you the study in the description. I would like to make a brief comment on low-intensity shockwaves. The idea why they are used in Peyronie's disease is that they activate the body's self-healing capacities. As I pointed out, they can't break up a calcified plaque, but they will lead to what we call remodeling. So the body is enabled to take care of the plaque. I won't go further into detail in this video. What about problems with ESWL? First of all, these machines are not designed for treating the penis. Just imagine this large applicator to be placed. It's difficult. In the article, you will find a picture of how it looks like. Likewise, it's extremely difficult to aim. This is why the treatment may not be effective after all. In my patient, they managed to take care of one plaque, but missed the remaining plaques many times over during the subsequent sessions. ESWL is high energy and it really hurts. you will need some kind of anesthesia for this. The penis will be black and blue afterwards, but that's a minor issue. One major problem is the availability of suitable machines. Technology constantly changes, and not all of the newer devices could be used on the penis, technically speaking. Here in Germany, ESWL machines have become rare in hospitals. Stones are treated with lasers nowadays. This may be different in other countries, but the lack of ESWL machines is a problem. No machine, no treatment. Anyway, I only advocate ESWL in selected patients. Please remember that this video is not medical advice. If you suffer from Peyronie's disease, please book an appointment with your local doctor. However, if you want an educational online consultation with me, you can book appointments now. I will put the link to my calendar in the description. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.